Hello everybody and welcome to a new video. M. Farooq Radwan is here and today's topic is how your relationship with your parent determines what happens in your romantic life. The first people that we come across in our lives are our fathers and mothers. The first male a person interacts with is their father, and the first female a person interacts with is their mother. If the relationship with the opposite sex parent was good, then probably we will end up looking for somebody who resembles that parent in a way or another. Let's suppose that a female was raised by a father that she loved a lot, and the father was loving and caring. In such a case, there is a significant possibility that this female is going to look for a man who resembles this father in a way or another. And when I say resembles, this doesn't mean that the person has to look like the father. While this is one form of resemblance, the other forms are the person talks in the same way, the person wears the same type of clothes, the person walks the same way, the person puts his mug or puts his cup the same exact way. Our subconscious mind can look for tremendous amount of information through our senses, and so any kind of resemblance will ring a bell to the subconscious mind and it will put that person in a favorable position in the mind just because they resembled the parent that we loved. In other words, if a guy loved his mother or if a female loved her father, then probably they are gonna look for people who resemble them when they enter the dating world. So what will happen if the person actually has a very bad relationship with their caregiver? What will happen if the person had a terrible relationship with their father or mother? In such a case, there are two possibilities. Possibility number one, that the person will avoid those who resemble their opposite sex parent in order to avoid the problem from repeating itself again. As human beings, we sometimes do our best, consciously and unconsciously, to prevent the bad past from ever repeating itself. This is the first case. The second case is that the person might look for another chance of redemption. In other words, the person might actually try to search for somebody who resembled their parent that they had a bad relationship with just to give themselves another chance of winning an approval that they never won, another chance to be loved in a way that they failed to get before according to their own perception, another chance to fix a broken relationship in a way or another. And this is a very interesting trick that the mind does always. In so many cases, we look for those who resemble people who treated us bad in the past, who dealt with us in a bad way, who rejected us in the past, just to get another chance of redemption. For the subconscious mind, being accepted by a similar person might have mean that you are actually worthy and that the rejection that happened in the past didn't really mean much. Also, another interesting takeaway you can get from here is that you can make yourself much more attractive to a person by simply resembling the parent or the opposite sex parent that they have a good relationship with. By resembling that figure, the person will find you unconsciously and consciously much more attractive and they might get attracted to you. And this is actually one of maybe more than 60 techniques that I described in my book, How to Make Someone Fall in Love with You by M. Farooq Radwan, that's me, and you will find this book on Amazon in hard copy. You can get this book by clicking on the link below, which will guide you to the rest of my books on Amazon. I hope you liked this video. That was the end today. I hope that you subscribe. Please join this channel and let me see you again. Until the next video, take care of yourselves and goodbye.